Hello, I'm Nick Diakopoulos, and I'll be your instructor for this MOOC on news algorithms. Thanks for joining me here. I'm really excited to have you enrolled to learn more about news algorithms and how automation and AI are impacting journalism. We're going to cover a lot of ground here, from algorithms in news production and distribution to how to investigate the power wielded by these things in society. The main goal of this course, though, is for you to acquire the knowledge you need to think more strategically, creatively, and responsibly about the adoption of these technologies in your practice. I'm not going to hype the tech here, but hopefully we can start to peel back a bit of the mystery around algorithms and AI so you have a greater appreciation for what it is they can and can't do for news production and journalism. Okay, so first off, I want to give you a bit more of a breakdown of the content of the course week by week. In week one, I'm going to give you a broad overview of how algorithmic approaches are being used throughout journalism, including in areas like content production and computational story discovery. We'll talk about which tasks algorithms are good at, which tasks people are still better at, and about how to blend the two together. We'll also talk about what it means to develop computational thinking skills and how to apply those skills in news production. In week two, we'll get into a lot more detail on automated content production, including how it works and how it's used by news organizations. We'll also talk about its benefits and limitations so that you know when it might be appropriate to deploy. And I'm going to show you the basics for how to write a template using a tool called Aria Studio, which is kind of like an alien word processor for creating automated content. For week three, we'll talk about algorithms in news curation and dissemination, like at Google, Facebook, and even Apple News, which all use algorithms in different ways to drive exposure to content. We'll also talk about how to think about metrics and how editorial criteria can be encoded into the curation algorithms that your own news organizations might even be developing. Finally, in our last week, I'll talk about how algorithms are creating a new target for journalistic investigation, which is giving rise to a specialized practice called algorithmic accountability reporting. I'll detail what methods you can use to investigate algorithms on this beat, and I'll talk about how you yourselves can be more responsible with the algorithms you might be incorporating into your news work. Now, in terms of the nuts and bolts structure of the course, each week I'm going to post some video lectures and some required readings. In order to do the course and complete it, you need to watch all the videos, do all the required readings, and also participate in the discussion forums so that you can ask questions and engage with other participants who are in the course. I'll also be in those forums every week, answering questions you may have and adding any information that I can. Each week, there's also going to be a quiz. It's not something to worry about if you're watching the lectures and reading the readings. The quiz is more to help you reinforce the information and knowledge you're gaining in the course. If you want to receive a certificate of completion at the end of the course, you'll need to watch the videos, read the readings, participate in the forums, and complete the quiz. As a bonus, I'll be interviewing leading practitioners every week to give you an inside view on how automation and AI are being used in newsrooms. There'll be some great information there, so you won't want to miss those either. So again, we're going to cover a lot of territory in 4 weeks. It's an overview course, but you should hope to come away with some knowledge you need to think more strategically, creatively, and responsibly about the adoption of these technologies in your practice. I hope you're looking forward to getting started. For now, you should introduce yourself in the forum and also review the syllabus and read the introductory readings that are posted there. Thanks again for signing up. I'll see you online and in the forums.